going on, guys? We'll go back to episode 7 of Daily MLB Recaps. We had a fun one yesterday in baseball. A lot of close games. We had an extra inning game between two heated rivals. We had a come-from-behind walk-off win and some very dominant pitching performances. So let's get into it. First game was Rockies and Athletics, and the Rockies take this one 5-1 off the strength of six innings pitched and only one run from Germán Márquez. Frankie Montas did not pitch very well, kind of got rocked around early in the A's, had no run support. It was just a solo home run for Matt Chapman. So the Rockies win that one 5-1. The Rangers defeat the Diamondbacks 7-4. This game was 2-2 going into the eighth inning until Eduardo Escobar with an RBI double to make this game 4-2. But in the bottom half of the eighth, Joey Gallo with this two-run home run ties the game. Later in the inning, with the bases loaded, Elvis Andrus smacks a ground ball up the middle. It gets through for a hit. Two more runs score, and the Rangers win this one 7-4. This next one between the Nats and Jays was a very highly anticipated pitching matchup for me. Max Scherzer against the, I would say, number two pitching prospect in all of baseball, the Blue Jays' Nate Pearson. This guy throws, he ticks 100 consistently. This, if you've used his prospect card on MLB The Show, you know how good this guy is. He pitched five innings, did not give up a single run, five strikeouts. Scherzer equally as good, pitching 7 1/3, also with no runs. So the game went to extra, tied 0-0. And starting with a runner on second, the Nationals completely jumped out and eventually ended up winning this game. They played in four in the 10th, and they win. The White Sox win 4-0 over the Indians. Zach Plesac for the Indians pitched eight innings, only gave up three hits, no earned runs, 11 strikeouts, and he gets saddled with a no decision because Lucas Giolito also pitched six innings, didn't give up any runs. So this game was also tied 0-0 headed into the top of the ninth until Brad Hand loaded the bases, gave up a sack fly to Yasmani Grandal. After another sack fly, Luis Robert came up and had a 2-RBI single to plate four runs, and that was all that the White Sox needed. They win that one 4-0. The Cubs fall to the Reds. The Reds put up 12 runs, winning this one 12-7. Homers from Moustakas, Castellanos, and Senzel. Castellanos was 2-for-3 with a home run, plated 4 RBIs in that game. Embarrassing as a Cubs fan. Kyle Hendricks got lit up after that great start he had the first game. Brewers defeat the Pirates 3-0. Brandon Woodruff pitched 6 1/3 innings, didn't give up a single run. Josh Hader closed it out for the save. Only one hit was given up by the Brewers pitching staff all day. Home runs from Ben Gamel and Kestrel Hero were all they needed to win that one 3-0. The Braves defeat the Rays 7-4. Freddie Freeman, and I think his second game back, he had, I think, the golden sombrero in his first game. 0-4, 4 Ks, or he had at least three. He came back with a vengeance this game, going 4-for-5 with a homer, plating 3 RBIs and scoring a run. And the Braves win this one 7-4 over the Rays. The Tigers win 5-4 over the Royals. Jacoby Jones went 3-for-3 with a home run, scoring two runs. Joe Jimenez locks down, I think, another save. How many saves does this guy have? Hold on. Stats. How many? I think he has 4 saves. Pretty sure. Let's take a look. Joe Jimenez has 4 saves in all 4 Tiger wins. That's crazy. This, man, that guy's really showing up when it matters the most. Joe Jimenez, attaboy. Way to produce. The next game we're going to talk about is, the Red Sox and Mets. So, Jacob DeGrom pitched very well. Pitched 6 innings, only gave up 2 runs. So, he did really good there. The Red Sox eventually rallied, though, once they took him out. It was, I think, 6-2. I think Cespedes hit a 2-run homer to make it 6-4. And then Brandon Workman in the bottom of the ninth trying to close out the save. He's like, let's load the bases. Nobody out. Okay. I think he struck out who did he strike out? He struck someone out. I think it was, I forget who. Then I remember Brandon Nimmo had an RBI infield single, and then he struck out Cano and Conforto to end the game. So the Red Sox win a nail biter 6-5. The Dodgers defeat the Astros 4-2 in 13 innings. The win goes to Dennis Santana, who I think pitched four scoreless innings out of relief. Okay, now, he gave up one run, but it was when the runner started on second, so that really doesn't count. Dennis Santana, absolute stud. He is definitely the player of the game for this one. It was 2-2 going into the top of the 13th. This Edwin Rios two-run bomb gives the Dodgers a lead, and it was a lead they would hold on for the bottom of the 13th inning. The Yankees defeat the Orioles 9-3. DJ LeMahieu led the offense in this one, going 4-for-5 with a homer, scoring two runs. Gerrit Cole went 6 2/3, gave up three runs, but with an offensive explosion like that, three runs is going to be quite all right. The Cardinals defeat the the Cardinals lose to the Twins 3-0. Rich Hill went five innings, only gave up two hits, no runs. Nelson Cruz had an RBI double, and Eddie Rosario hit a solo home run. Daniel Ponce de Leon pitched well, but not good enough for the win. Taylor Rogers locks down a save. The Padres and the Giants. So this game was 2-2 through about midway through. Then Manny Machado and Trent Grisham both hit a solo shot, and then a three-run shot from Trent Grisham made it 6-2. Padres were 4-1. You're like, they're going to roll to another win. This team's looking like one of the best in baseball. The Giants did not go away quietly. A solo home run from Alex Dickerson. And then I think it's Dante Solano. He hit a three-run shot to tie the game. And then going into the bottom of the ninth, there was, I think, two people sitting in McCovey Cove, and this guy, he just had an orange sweatshirt that said Dave on it. And Mike Yastrzemski hit one into the water earlier in the game. It was a solo home run. He comes up again and hits an absolute rocket into McCovey Cove. He walks it off, and Dave gets his second home run ball of the game. Imagine getting two home run balls from the same player. That's pretty cool. That's why I want to go to a San Francisco game and just kayak out there. Giants walk it off 7-6. They're 3-3. They're not looking too bad. Dramatic come from behind win. And lastly, the Mariners and Angels in an absolute slugfest. The Mariners win that one 10-7. Justin Upton hit his 300th home run, so that was fun. Brian Goodwin and Ohtani also went deep, but it was the attitude of just keeping the line moving for Seattle. Kyle Lewis was hitting well. Kyle Seager's also on a tear. Dylan Moore went yard. Evan White was getting hits. All around a 10-run performance for the Mariners. They win that one 10-7 as Dan Altavilla locks down a save. Your player of the day is Mike Yastrzemski. Two home runs, including a walk-off. That's impressive. Now, your play of the day. I know you guys are going to want me to say the Chris Bryant triple play. So he dove to his right, he caught the ball, tagged third base, doubled up the runner, then threw it back to first to double up the runner. Okay, everyone's going to say, he dropped the ball. It doesn't matter. Okay, yeah, he did drop the ball. The ump said he caught it. It was a bad call. But I don't even if he did catch it, I still don't think that's the best play of the game. Check out this play from Kevin Kiermaier. Ball is hit over the head of right fielder Hunter Renfroe. Kiermaier perfectly backs him up on the run, spins through, makes a perfect throw to Brandon Lau. Brandon Lau makes a perfect relay throw home to Mike Zunino, and Ronald Acuna is dead meat at home plate. That is your play of the day from one of the best center fielders to ever do it out there. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode of MLB Baseball Recaps, and I will see you tomorrow for episode 8.